There has never been a bigger and more exciting season for sports betting. Winning season at MyBookie is all about doubling your deposit, cashing in on free bets, super contests, survivor streaks, and more. Every cent with $1,000 will be met with a match up to $1,000, so you can get your bets in for the game between the Texans and the Chiefs on Thursday night. All you have to do is use your promo code HOLLY to claim your extra cash. That's code HOLLY at mybookie.com for dollar-to-dollar deposit match. Winning season is here, and it's only with MyBookie.
I was the weird homeschooled kid. So I never
Worry. Watch out for those homeschooled kids.
We're coming to get you.
You're all so weird.
We really are. But no, it was good in a lot of sense because it kept me away from a lot of, like, general trouble making, drinking, doing drugs. So I actually never even smoked cannabis until my doctor recommended it to me at the age of 20.
Wow.
Because I was so thin and I never had an appetite.
Yeah.
And he was like, well, you could take these pills or you could smoke some weed.
Yeah. I remember you talking about that because now you're obviously like a big cannabis advocate and you have your own company. So I remember you telling me that, like, you had problems eating.
Yeah.
That your stomach hurt a lot, and it wasn't until you started smoking weed that like, changed everything for you.
It did. It totally changed my life. I went from being, like, someone that you would look at and you would assume, like, okay, this person obviously has, like, an eating disorder. Mm-hmm. And I guess you could generalize it that way, but it's not an eating disorder I can control in any way.
It's just, you're not anorexic in the sense that, like, you have body dysmorphia and you think that you're fat and you're not eating because of that. You generally, like, have, like...
Like, food sounds and, like, the idea and the thought of it almost makes me want to throw up.
Really?
Yes. And it's gotten even more difficult since the accident because I ruptured 3 organs as well as broke my back during the accident.
Jesus.
So it's eating is very difficult.
Interesting. Do you have only, like, specific things that you like to eat when you do eat, or, like,
I do actually.
Okay.
It's cut down a lot of what I'm able to eat and how much. I can't have any energy drinks, any coffee really, any overcaffeinated stuff is really bad. Heavy meats will just, like, make me go into, like, little ball on the floor and just be in terrible pain.
Yeah.
So, but it's just going to take a couple years because it was massive trauma to my stomach, intestines, duodenum, and my pancreas.
Okay. So. Wow. I have, like, so many things that I want to talk to you about because obviously the accident's definitely, like, on that list because that was, like, a huge, you know, obviously life-changing event. And I remember when that happened, I was so worried about you.
And you sent me those flowers. I still have the card.
Aww,
she sent me flowers to my room with the sweetest card, and I keep it always next to my bed.
Aw, that's so great. Well, I mean, okay, so I guess let's go into... actually, you know what? Hold on. Let's back up.
Yeah.
Let's finish the... Because I want us to talk about the cannabis stuff.
Yes.
And I want to talk about your company. I want to talk about, like, the activism that you do and that kind of stuff. And then we'll go into your accident.
Yes.
These are all areas we need to cover.
Right? There's so many things.
I know. There's so many things. I haven't seen you in so long. Okay. So the accident.
Yes. Or cannabis.
No. Yes. Fuck. Oh, boy. Okay. Cannabis.
Cannabis
life.
Yes. It is honestly, it's the best thing for almost anything. They're finding so many different ways to use it. I grow my own just because I am really afraid of what people are putting into it. As we come into this new legalization, they're creating all these gray areas and they're changing laws constantly and so swiftly that the growers can't keep up. So they're kind of tricking the little grower guys out of everything to give it to the corporations.
That's what I've heard. So I remember when the legalization of cannabis came onto the ballot, I had a friend who is also in the field, and he was talking about how this was going to be a huge problem, and basically the government was taking the cannabis market and, like, commercializing it for, like, corporations and taking it away from, you know, mom and pop kind of growers.
And that's, like, my big concern, and because what I'm really afraid of is what they're going to be putting into it, because the people that I know that grow, like, there's a wonderful group of people, the Jungle Boys here in LA, the TLC Collective, absolutely love them. They grow everything in-house, and they're just really there to care for the patient. They want you to know that this isn't about you know, us like really like making money. We want to help you if you have back pain, if you have anxiety, if you have seizures, you know, whatever it may be. But they come in and they actually have to have lawyers that they stole from NASA write all of their contracts to submit. And that's just one draft cost them. I think they said roughly $250,000.
Jesus.
So it's like every draft that they have to write for submitting for a new anything cost them $250,000. And it's absurd.
Wow. Is that so they need these lawyers because the laws are always changing and because there's such like unsure footing?
Yep.
And yeah, because I there's, you know, obviously like there's been a lot of cannabis places popping up all over the place. And I remember there was one near my house that like got raided. I remember seeing the cops there and like they raided it. And just out of curiosity, I asked the guy, I was like, what happened? And they're like, we don't know. Like they just came, they had like, you know, because it's illegal on a federal level, but it's legal on a state level. Yep. So it's like super confusing. And also too, like won't banks like not...
Banks won't work with you.
Yeah. So then you're working on a purely cash business, which is dangerous to have to deal with that much cash. It makes it so much easier for people to rob you.
Yes.
I mean, it's just like, it's almost like being in the adult industry.
Oh, it really is.
You know, because you know how like banks will have shut down like accounts of porn stars and stuff like that?
I've had that happen to so many people and it's just like, it's such a bummer.
Yeah.
Because it's no one's doing any harm to anyone else. We're just trying to run a business.
And it's not an illegal business either. Not on a federal level like pot is, if you want to make that argument.
Yes.
Like, it's not illegal what we're doing.
No.
And I remember actually applying for a credit card, and I was denied. And I talked to the guy, and I was like, I just want to know why. Like, I have good credit. Like, I have plenty of money coming through. Like, I'm never late paying my bills. And he was like, well, he's like, you know, I'm going to be honest with you. Like, we Googled you and we saw, you know, and we don't support adult content because...
Wow.
I forgot what his reason was, but it was something like that it was unstable or something like that. And I was like, I'm sorry, but like my business has been way more stable through this recession than like so many mainstream industries. Like up until this last recession, we kind of thought we were recession proof. You know how like alcohol and like cigarettes and like porn is like recession proof?
Because
if anything, people turn to that when they're down.
Exactly.
So yeah, I was just like, that is such bullshit. But the thing is, because banks are private institutions, they can do that.
They can.
Unfortunately.
Which is really, it's such a bummer. Because these cannabis companies really, they're not trying to hurt anyone. If anything, they're trying to help so many people.
Right, right.
And then the taxation on it is just absurd. If you don't have your recreational card, I would say go get your rec card because the taxes are not going down. They're going up. Mm. So you're paying 38% on every dollar.
Wow.
And it's just absurd. So if you have your medical card, which you can get very, very easily, and then your taxes are way lower on your purchasing options.
So that's how they're making the difference between they're charging a lot more for recreational users as opposed to medical users.
Yes.
That makes sense.
Yeah. And I understand, but it kind of is hypocritical when it comes to the tobacco and the alcohol industries when they're all charged the same percentage of taxes across the board, really.
Yeah. And also, too, if you think about it, like, and it, you know, obviously there are certain people that will probably argue with this, but as opposed to alcohol and cigarettes, which is definitely not medicine.
I mean, yes.
Once again, people might argue with that, but like cannabis literally is medicine, and
it's been
obviously
proven.
Obviously people use it for non-medical reasons, but a lot of people do use it for medical reasons.
Mm-hmm.
So like to have it kind of treated the same way.
Especially when it can be extracted down to its most base compounds, which is the CBD compound, which is the muscle and just the things that help you. The THC is the psychoactive side.
Yeah.
But for anyone with epilepsy and seizures or anything or cerebral palsy, this is a lifesaver.
Yeah.
And we're going to deny people something that they can get at a reasonable price that will vastly improve their lives.
Yeah.
I hope people kind of like wake up and are just like, okay, we need to lower the taxes a little bit and not be so harsh on this.
Yeah. So do you have your own growing business?
I grow for my personal self now.
Okay.
Because I'm working mostly on my clothing line now and all of my art that's coming out.
But you did have a growing business at one point, right?
I did, actually. Now I mostly help promote companies that I believe in, like the Jungle Boys. Sticky Vapes is a new one that I've discovered. They're amazing. They're disposable, too. So they come in this great packaging. They're stainless steel. It just it looks elegant. It's clean. And you just get this great, perfect thing.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, I think it's just the way to go.
Yeah. It's incredible, like, how to see the way that it's changed and it's morphed. I mean, I remember it like senior year of high school. This was 1996, people. My boyfriend wrote a story. It was like his like big like English paper project, and it was about why weed should be legal and why it was illegalized in the DuPont paper industry and all this stuff. And I remember him saying to me, he's like, weed's gonna be legal one day. He's like, just you wait and see it is. And I was like, you're crazy, it's never gonna be legal. And here we are,
so many uses.
Yeah.
And it's just sad to think that it was just really the transition of, well, we don't want to pay the money to transition from lumber and timber and those things to hemp and cannabis. And
right.
And the pharmaceutical reps obviously had their hands in it. But
yes.
Everyone's got a little claw on that one.
Yeah, I know, right? There has never been a bigger and more exciting season for sports betting. Winning season at MyBookie is all about doubling your deposit, cashing in on free bets, super contests, survivor streaks, and more. Every cent with $1,000 will be met with a match up to $1,000, so you can get your bets in for the game between the Texans and the Chiefs on Thursday night. All you have to do is use your promo code HOLLY to claim your extra cash. That's code HOLLY at mybookie.com for dollar-to-dollar deposit match. Winning season is here, and it's only with MyBookie. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the show, make sure that you subscribe so you don't miss a single episode. And go check out all the other videos. I film every single one of my podcasts. And if you want to listen to the audio version, I'm on iTunes and all the other podcast platforms. Visit HollyRandallUnfiltered.com to find out more.